I know that Joanne told you she didn't want people to think that Fred Rogers was a saint. He was a man that worked out his faith, that was a great impact. Talk a little bit about that. That, because I think a lot of people do put people on a pedestal, and you think, well, those are those kind of people. We can never be like those kind of people.
And that was what she said. That was why it was important that we didn't think of him as a saint, because then we can't aspire to be like him. And I think the thing that Fred tried to teach, or what I've gained from spending all of this time getting to know him, was that he felt like we could all work on our kindness. We could all work to be our better selves. We could all call on that part of ourself that is better. And I've had a lot of people ask me recently, like, who is the person who's going to take up the mantle and be the next Fred Rogers? And the answer that I've been giving is, I think it's all of us. It's all of us who need to do that. You know, what I took away from Fred is that you don't have to do big things in order to be a hero. You don't have to save the world in order to change somebody's life. It can be small acts. It can be helping one child. It can be being kind to one stranger, that these things can make huge differences in people's lives. You have no idea the differences you can make. You telling me that my interviews have meant something to you, or that you felt my heart. I mean, what that type of a connection does between people, you know, like that these are, this was what I gained from it, was the idea that we can all make choices in our life to be more kind. We can make choices toward compassion. That's awesome.